adjective. What is an adjective? Adjective is a word which says about the quality of a noun. Yes, it qualifies a noun. Just we'll have some example here. Ram is good. This is a sentence. Ram, noun, is, verb. What is good? It says about the quality of a noun. Ram elanti vadu. Ram is good. Ram is bad. Ram is clever. Ram is a fool. Ram is tall. Ram is short. Ram is white. Ram is black. Ram is brilliant. Ram is poor. Ram is rich. Likewise, it says about the quality of a noun. Good is an adjective here in the sentence saying about the quality of this noun. So good is the adjective. Next, adverb. Adverb is a word. It is there in its name itself. Add verb. It adds something to the verb. It adds something to the verb. So adverb is a word which adds something to the verb. Let us see some example how an adverb adds something to a verb. It really adds something to the verb. See, Ram is good. Ram is slow. Ram is a noun, is a verb. Slow is the quality of the noun, so adjective. Ram did it well. Ram did it well. Ram, noun. Did, verb. It, pronoun. Well. Ram did. I did. Sita did. But Ram did well. So, this well adds something to the verb. Yes. I will quote another example. Ram completed early. Ram completed early. Completed late. Completed early. Completed early. So this early is an adverb because it is adding something to this verb completed. So adverb is a word which adds something to the verb. That is not enough to define an adverb. It has two more roles, like I will explain you. Adverb adds something to a verb or an adjective also. An adjective, it adds something to an adjective. We will see. He is good is a sentence. He, noun or pronoun. Is verb. Good, adjective. Because it is qualifying this noun or pronoun. Yes. He is good is a sentence. He is very good is also a sentence. Here you see very good. He is very good. Good, adjective. This very is adding something to this adjective. So here Ram completed early. This early is an adverb which is adding something to this verb completed. Here you see, good is an adjective, this very is an adverb which is adding something to the adjective here. This is one condition, this is the other condition. The third condition and third role which is played by this adverb is, adverb adds something to a verb or an adjective or another adverb. It can add something to another adverb also, like you see, you see the sentence, he is a very good boy. All about adverb. Adverb is a word which adds something to a verb, as it is very clearly mentioned in its name itself. And not only that, added to that, another role is played by an adverb, like it is adding something to an adjective. Good, very good. So it is adding something to an adjective. So very is an adverb here. And coming to the third role of an adverb, here you see, this is a noun. This good is an adjective because it is qualifying this noun, and very is an adverb because it is qualifying good. And very is added by a, because very is added by a because this a as an adverb adding something to another adverb. That is what it is. So role number one, adding something to the verb. Role number two, adding something to the adjective. Role number three, adding something to another adverb. That is what an adverb is. Okay, next, coming to other part of speech. Now coming to the next part of speech, it is preposition. What is a preposition? You see, I will just write one sentence. Observe this sentence. You see, observe these two sentences. The pen is on the table. The pen is in the desk. You see, on, in. These are the words. Here it is on and here it is in. These two are called prepositions. What these words are doing here, you see, the pen is on the table. We cannot say the pen is in the table. That is wrong usage of preposition, and there is no proper sensible meaning for the sentence if you write in here in place of on. So it should be on only here. So what a preposition does is, a preposition is a word which links a noun to the remaining part of the sentence or rest of the sentence for a sensible meaning. Likewise, you see it here, the pen is in the desk. So the preposition to be used here is in only. Other than in, if you use any other preposition, the meaning will get spoiled. So preposition is a word not only here, here and everywhere. Preposition is a word which is used to link a noun to the rest of the sentence for a sensible meaning. That is what it is. Preposition is that. So I will write another example, like you see, the river is flowing under the bridge. It is quite common sentence. Everybody knows about the flowing of a river under the bridge only, not anywhere. So this is the river is flowing under the bridge. Under is the preposition here. It is just joining the bridge or the river with the rest of the sentence to give a sensible meaning. Just I will rewrite this sentence with a little change. Try to observe that. The river is flowing over the bridge. Due to heavy cyclone. You see the sentence. The river is flowing over the bridge due to heavy cyclone. Here, because of the change, under has become over. What happened here? You see, the river is flowing over the bridge because of this reason. Due to heavy cyclone. Due to heavy cyclone, the water is more and more heavy. That is the reason the river is flowing over the bridge. So here the preposition is over. So if you write under here, it will be wrong. You have mentioned the very specific reason here that the cyclone is very heavy. What might be the reason of the river flowing over the bridge? This is the reason. So because of that, this preposition has become over here, not under here. So that is the role of a preposition, which links a noun to the rest of the sentence for a sensible meaning. Okay, I got it? Right. Now, next part of speech is conjunction. What is it? Conjunction. What is a conjunction? I will write some sentence here for you to observe. You see, pen and pencil, these two are the nouns, these two are the things. They are joined by a conjunction and here. This is the conjunction. What is its role here? It is joining two things. Pen and pencil are here. When this and joins these two things, this entire subject has become plural. That is another role. We will definitely do some exercise on that later, not now. Pen and pencil, and is the conjunction here which is joining two things. So conjunction is a word which joins two things, two words. Not only that, in addition to that, there is some other role for a conjunction, like it joins two parts of a sentence also, like you see here. See, read the sentence. I ran fast and got the train. Observe this. This and is a conjunction here which is joining two parts here. I ran fast and got the train. I ran fast is one part of the sentence and got the train is another part of the sentence. These two parts are joined wonderfully by this conjunction and here. You see, I am going to write another example. I ran fast, so I got the train. What is the conjunction here? Yes, exactly. So is the conjunction here. It is playing a role of joining two parts. I ran fast, I got the train. This is the conjunction, so. You see, I am rewriting this sentence with a little change. I ran fast, but I missed the train. See the role of conjunction here. What is the conjunction? Nenu baga parigettanu, nenu train miss ayyanu. Akkada vache conjunction chusara, so has become but here. See this sentence, observe this. I got the train because I ran fast. నేను ట్రైన్ అందింది ఎందువలన అనగా నేను వేగంగా పరిగెత్తాను. ఇక్కడ కన్జంక్షన్ బికాస్. సి యూ అబ్జర్వ్ దిస్ సెంటెన్స్. ఐ మిస్ ఇన్ ది ట్రైన్ ఈవెన్ దో ఐ ర్యాన్ ఫాస్ట్. నేను ట్రైన్ మిస్ అయ్యాను వేగంగా పరిగెత్తినప్పటికీ. దిస్ ఈజ్ ద కన్జంక్షన్ హియర్. యు సీ ది బ్యూటీ ఆఫ్ ది కన్జంక్షన్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ రోల్. యు సీ దిస్ ఈజ్ ద రోల్ ఆఫ్ ది కన్జంక్షన్. కన్జంక్షన్ ఈజ్ ఎ వర్డ్ విచ్ జాయిన్స్ టూ వర్డ్స్ ఆర్ టూ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ టూ పార్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ది సెంటెన్స్. Okay, right. And now the eighth one, last one. What is it? Yes, interjection. Interjection. See, I will write one sentence. Please observe this. Manu ekkuga vintu untam ee sentence. ఈ క్రికెట్ మ్యాచెస్లో వింటూ ఉంటాం, ఫుట్బాల్లో వింటూ ఉంటాం, టెన్నిస్లో వింటూ ఉంటాం. ఓ వాట్ ఏ షాట్. యు సీ దిస్ సెంటెన్స్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్. ఓ వాట్ ఏ షాట్, సడన్ సర్ప్రైజ్. టు ఎక్స్ప్రెస్ అవర్ సడన్ సర్ప్రైజ్ వీ యూజ్ సమ్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ వర్డ్స్ ఆఫ్ దిస్. దీస్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ ఇంటర్జెక్షన్స్. ఓ ఈజ్ అన్ ఇంటర్జెక్షన్ హియర్. అండ్ ఆల్సో యు సీ అనదర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. వావ్. Wow, what an art it is! ఎంత అద్భుతమైనటువంటి కళాఖండము ఇది. ఎక్స్ట్రాఆర్డినరీ ఫీలింగ్, సడన్ సర్ప్రైజ్. నాట్ ఓన్లీ దాట్, అండ్ థర్డ్ రోల్ ఈజ్ దేర్ ఫర్ ఇంటర్జెక్షన్ లైక్ అలాస్. షీ ఈజ్ డెడ్. అలాస్ మీన్స్ అయ్యయ్యో, అరరే, a deep sorrow anamata. So interjection is a word which is used to give a kind of expression like sudden surprise, extraordinary feeling, deep sorrow. These are the roles played by interjection. So that is the eighth one and final one, interjection. And now we'll have a quick glance over what we have learned in this session. English is a language for communication. We are now dealing with general English. General English has so many chapters, out of which parts of speech is one of the chapters. So in English, how many parts of speech are there? 8 parts of speech are there, namely noun, pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. These are the 8 parts. So the first one is noun. Noun deals with the names of the things, persons, places. Pronoun is a word which is used in place of a noun. Verb. Verb deals with an action, a position, or a possession. And now coming to adjective. Adjective is a word which qualifies a noun. And now next one is adverb. In its name itself, it is there, it adds something to a verb. Not only that, added to that, it plays two more roles, like adding something to an adjective or something to another adverb. And coming to preposition, preposition is a word which links a noun to the rest of the sentence for a sensible meaning. And conjunction. Conjunction is a word which joins two words, two things, or two parts of a sentence. And interjection, and final thing is interjection, and which is a word used to give an expression of extraordinary feeling, sudden surprise, or deep sorrow. That is what all about parts of speech. And I hope you all have well understood about the parts of speech with examples also. And in our next classes, we deal with next chapters. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.